Before we get started with the next race, folks, I just want to send a big congratulations to Lewis Hamilton on his fifth world title. Congratulations, good sir. You are among the all-time greats. More on that shortly. And now, on to the action! Today, Saints, Kenzie Retchell here, back once again with my second race of the day for F1 2018.
I recommend we could go for something like this.
Then we shall do that then. So, anyway, what we've got, it is a case of, like I say, a big congratulations to Lewis Hamilton on his fifth world title. He joins Juan Manuel Fangio. And, of course, the great Michael Schumacher. As one of three men to have won five world titles. But this season, I'm more concerned about winning a third title. Here we go.
Welcome to qualifying for this weekend's French Grand Prix. The teams are making their last-minute adjustments before the lights go green and the fight for pole position gets underway. Now then, Anthony Davidson, you're not getting any younger, but you have been involved in your fair share of qualifying sessions in an illustrious 30-year career. How do you deal with the pressure when you have that one chance to deliver a perfect lap?
It's not so much about dealing with the pressure, it's more about how you approach the risk and just how much of it are you willing to take. You're constantly balancing the car on the edge of grip from braking, cornering and traction. And over the course of a lap, it's easy to get that balance wrong. And that's why achieving the perfect lap is almost impossible. As you say, I've been doing this 30 years now and it never gets any easier.
Here we go.
Right, it's not going to be easy getting into the next qualifying session, but we know you'll give it your all.
We intend to do just that. Let's not waste any time. Let's just go for it. Very tricky layout here. My first time racing on this circuit in game. French Grand Prix used to be held at the Manicourt circuit. But for the better part of a decade, French Grand Prix was never on the calendar. The last time it was held was back in 2018. Couple more upgrades. Package program perfected. And two objectives complete as well, alongside your own duties as well. Only you need to develop the story, don't know what it means. What do I have in store for this week?
Fantastic. That was the fastest lap.
What do I have on top? Again. Oh, it's a tough one to say. What I've got lined up for this week, but I've got something. Music cover. As always, on the Monday. And it's one that's just hot off the press in regards to one of my favourite artists.
There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
Stay tuned for that one, folks. What I have planned for Tuesday, but Wednesday, reactions to the latest episode of Walking Dead. That keeps me at the top for now. Absolutely balls it up in the air. Like that. Oh, Verstappen in second place. Ah. Now, who got eliminated? Stroll. Not surprising. Salvers and Toro Rosso's again. Right, on to Q2. Right, now, gonna go on to the super soft. Them to start the race. And Wednesday, I'd say I've got my Walking Dead reactions. Brand new playthrough lined up for back Thursday's reason I've got a brand new fleet to go back to is because one particular section of the Dragon, I guess, couldn't complete it. I just got to the point where I was like, this is going to cause me too much frustration, so I might as well quit while I'm ahead. Off. Six. Okay, that's a little concerning. Seven. Only down to 8. We had Ocon, Grosjean, Magnussen, Perez, Vandoorne. Okay. You guys want to check how many pole positions I've had? Now you can check out the F1 2018 playlist you can get up. And pay attention to the end card at the end of the video. Ooh, half a ticket, excellent! Get across the line. Yes! 35.5. That puts me on pole position for now.
Our best lap so far is a 1 minute 35.5.
Dang it! Raikkonen just stole it from me. Right. Time to up my game. Can somebody answer that phone? Dang it! Right. Fresh set. Now. Let's go. got. Come on. Why can it need an outro back here? Where does that put me? Do I keep pole position?
The grid is all set. For now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
Reputation for Williams. Woo!
Well done. That was a good qualifying performance.
Thanks, Emma. Jeff. Good to know. And I don't have any ultrasounds. Damn it. Scratch that. Yes, I do. Woo! Sucker. Yeah, that'll do. Now, formation. Here we go.
Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can.
Win this race today. From the fourth win of the season. From Raikkonen and Vettel on the well, let's run through the grid order. So let's have a look. I'm I'm the only one on super soft tires. And away we go. Okay, start. And there go the Ferraris. But I'm not giving up the lead that easily. There we go. Just like that. Vectro in the lead. Right out of the gate.
We're looking good from the start.
Good to know, Jeff. Very fast paced surface. Long straight, all but typical sections midway through the lap. This is the double apex David Croft was on about. That's 10, and that's 11. Reminiscent of Spooker from Suzuka, which we'll get into later. Look at that! 3.9 seconds already! I'll take that, thank you very much! Gap's now 4.5. I don't think there's going to be any stopping me today. So, all that's left to say is, when I get onto the next straight, wait for it. Sayonara, suckers! Next, it's Ricardo coming in. Same with Vettel, they're both coming in. So Grosjean in second place. How's about that? A Haas, a Williams, a Haas, and a Force India. 1, 2, 3. How's about that? Oh, someone's gone! Verstappen! No! Come on! Just when I thought things couldn't get any worse. There's Verstappen. DRS open. Oh! Oh! Right, listen to that! Oh, you blithering fool! Who was that he tagged anyway? Who was that he just... Oh, that is... Come on, that is just flat out unacceptable! my word, it was Bottas he tagged. Right. Let's check the... Well, the only damage it looked like Verstappen sustained was front wing damage, but it looks like it's a lot more serious than that. I think he's damaged his suspension. I think his suspension's gone. Nope. Yep, he's gone. Verstappen's a goner. Looks like Red Bull's bad luck has transferred over here. Why do I say that? Ricardo with another DNF today in Mexico. Rotten bit of luck for him. To which you've got to think to yourself, can Ricardo's season get any worse? He has just had the worst run of luck possible. Holy moly! That's not overheating, that's basic. That's on the verge of kaboom territory. Look at that, 107, 108, it's peaked at 108 right now, goodness me, I've got to try and cool my front tires down, otherwise I'm in a lot of bother.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
Not concerned about that now, Jeff. How much stress is going into my tires, the outside of my tires, that's what's causing the inside of my tires to overheat. Wow. Didn't expect that sort of news to come through. It's not news regarding me, thankfully, but it's... Yesterday was a tragic day for the world of football, or soccer for those watching in across the pond over in the States. But the owner of Leicester City Football Club sadly has confirmed has passed away in yesterday's helicopter crash just outside the King Power Stadium where Leicester City played their home games. It's a difficult name to pronounce, so I'm not even going to attempt it, but my thoughts and prayers are now with his family at a difficult time after such a tragic day. A Brighton football fan also passed away during a match yesterday, and Glenn Hoddle, England legend, in hospital. And then we have this helicopter crash. Nope, I said there was 5 people on board the helicopter and nobody survived that crash. So what I'm going to do now is, for the rest of this race, I'm going to be turning my camera off. And it's just going to be the race itself. Just as a, my microphone's going to be turned off as well as my camera. What you're just going to see from here on out is just the gameplay that I've recorded. Just, this is just as a sign of respect to the owner of Leicester City and those that were also tragically killed in that helicopter crash. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Doing one more stop today, one stop left in our strategy. Maneuver. You made it look easy. Okay, clear. some information on Hamilton. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Is 19.7 seconds. Let's use some of this energy, increase the ERS deployment. Seconds. They're on fresh softs. We think they've got two stops remaining. Please stay clear of the white line on the exit. You'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. To consider switching to a lower fuel mix, we may not finish on the current settings. Thank you. is 6.8 seconds. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Top job, my friend, top job. I was a bit worried about this one at the start of the weekend, but you pulled through. Thank you.
Here's our winner, pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
And now it's time to wind down and celebrate after that fantastic Grand Prix. Here they come, your top three, out onto the podium. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. The Rainmaster increases their championship lead. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Kevin Magnussen. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
On to the constructors then. We saw a dip in form from the championship leaders today. Their lead has taken a significant blow. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye, and see you again next time.
Amazing performance out there. You must be really happy.
You must be happy with the result today. It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash?
Great! Well, that's everything.
Fantastic podium. Well done. Keep pushing like this for the rest of the season. It's time for us to renegotiate your contract. Here you can see the current deal. Once negotiations begin, the team will make you an offer. You can accept if you like, but I strongly suggest we push for better terms. They aren't coming round to that proposal. Let's try something else. All right, the terms have been agreed. All that's left is to sign the paperwork. You'll be on this new deal from the next race weekend.
What do you think of this one?